This week we're going to get a file ready for laser engraving. Hi guys, back again for another week. This week we're going to show you how to set up a laser engraved file in CorelDRAW. First thing we're going to have to do is go to your welcome screen. All you do is just set up a new document, and when the new document comes in, I've got mine set to a preset just named my laser machine, which is the RayJet. And you've got to set the width to be 457 millimeters and the height to be 305. And that's the settings for this laser that I've got here, because that's the actual bed cutting size. And you also just do the color mode needs to be an RGB, and the rendering resolution just 300 will do, but it doesn't really need to be specified as precisely. Sometimes you might even go up to like 600, 900, or even 1000 DPI, depending on what files you want to make. So just cancel that one, because I've got one open right here. So you can see there it's 457 wide by 305 high is the main area. So just say I'm going to grab a box. I make up a box size of this size here and set the box to a hairline. Oops. Let me press on that. So set the box up to being a hairline, and you can make that, so a lot of times you engrave it in red. So now you've made a pure red outline. So if you look down here, it's just pure red, which is 25500. And that the laser is going to be able to see that as being a cut line, right? And then the next thing that you can do is you can set up other colors like I have here, and make each different color do a little bit different operation. So first of all, you do black inside, so everywhere inside that is going to engrave, and then you got that red outline, which means it'll cut it out. So if we just go back a step, and what we'll do is make a box within the box, and we'll make that one black. So now what's going to happen here for my laser file is that the black box just here will engrave, that there will be left just blank the way it is, and then the red outline will end up cutting. I could also set up in a different way to make, just say, another box again within this, and I'll change that to a hairline blue. So now I've got the hairline there, so I've got the thickness to be a hairline, and the color is going to be that blue there, which is just a standard blue, which is just a 0, 2550. And then what's going to happen here is the engraver is going to come down and it's going to engrave that box out, then it'll come back up, it'll cut that, or it'll just, depending on the setting that you make, it'll just make a etch line. So it's going to follow that line around doing an etch, and then it'll run around and do a cut. So that way you've got the different thicknesses in your material when you're cutting it. So that's basically it. So if you'd like to just go to we'll just go to print, and you go to your print preferences. I set it up to be for the RayJet, so that way it's all aligned within that square. Go to your preferences when this thing finally loads up, and then now you just change your settings to suit, and just say we're going to engrave it onto wood. We'll make it engrave balsa wood, just say. And what you've got there, so you've only got the two settings here. So first of all, you've got the black setting, which is going to be an engrave, and we're engraving it at this power and this speed. Then you also change it to a cut. The air assist is turned on, you've got one pass, and it's going to be cut at that amount. And then you can also set, because we have a blue line in here, set the blue one up to also be a cut, but you'd cut it at a different speed and power. So you probably mimic the power that's on this one. So that's 100 over here. And we could even leave that one as 50, because that's 32. We'll make that cut so it's a little bit deeper, because it is going to go over a little bit faster. So you could set that up for an etched line, a cut line. It's got a lot more power and a lot slower speed. And then that there's going to be engraving, and there's your different effects. You can also go into here and change the way the it's engraving, but in this image here, you've only got black and white and then the cut and edge lines. So you just leave it on black and white there for the moment. We'll go through all the other ones later on, what they can do and a better image for that type of thing. But just for this video, that's it. Oh, thank you very much for watching this video. And if you liked it, please thumbs up, comment, or make sure you do subscribe. Thank you.